Nahitaji ndio yako Yesu tu. Nahitaji ndio yako Yesu tu. Ninataka ndio yako Yesu tu. Ndio yako ndio itanisimamisha. Ndio yako itanifungulia milango. What's up, guys? This is your very own Gloria Muliro hanging out with the best site for breaking news in Kenya, tuko.co.ke. Stay locked. She's a Kenyan. She's a gospel artist. She's born again. Passionate about serving God. Yeah, she's just enjoying life. Yeah, so that's in a nutshell about Gloria. Yeah, thank you that you mentioned career, because as a career I started in 2010. That's when I started full-time ministry, full-time just serving God through music and living on music. That was in 2010. No, I'm planning to go to school now, but I've never been to a music school. The only I have learned on the job, if I can say so, I've learned my being on the altar, singing on different platforms. I have been learning as I do it. I am a teacher by profession. I joined the TTC in 2002 up to 2004. Then I began teaching in school in 2004 up to 2010. I was teaching. No, I was teaching in a private school. And then at some point I joined, I was employed by one of the NGOs, charity NGOs. So, but I was still teaching. It was kind of a rehab application. I was still teaching. And that's where I taught for long, because I taught for 5 years there. Then I quit in 2010. The way I'm dressed, this is music. Where I live, music. Food I eat every day, music. I live on music. Yes. If I would not be singing, I would be singing. So music to me is life. Edward, challenges are so many. And you know, every stage comes with its own challenges. Like when I started and where I am now, the challenges I went through starting are not the same. So now I'm facing different, for lack of a better word, different devils. Because every level comes with its own devils, you know. But thank God for the grace, because we make it by the grace of God. Starting, like I said, I didn't believe in myself so much, because I didn't think I have a good voice. And so I sounded horrible. I don't think I sound horrible now. So I overcame that challenge, and then I didn't have enough money to do good production. So even my first album, come out, you know, if you've not seen it, please have a look. But yeah, looking at my first album, you can tell I was very low, I was very down. Financially, I was down, so I could not do good production. So. Then I overcame that. God helped me along the way, because if you look at the production I'm doing now, it's different from the one I did that time. Yeah, so, and then like now, everyone, especially in Kenya, knows Gloria Muliro. They have heard my songs, they have seen some of the good videos I've done. The expectation is high. So that's another challenge, not really in a negative way, but in a positive way, because to me, it gives me a motivation to work hard, to think hard, to read the Bible, to pray hard, and tell God, give me another message for your people. You know what they need, so God, give me a song. And then when God gives me a song, I have to make sure that I do very good production, because I cannot afford to do anything less, because Kina Edward are waiting for my next song, just singing what I feel is in me. The inspiration, just bringing out the inspiration, whichever way it comes, through the Bible, through prayer, through observation of what is happening in lives of people, through what I'm going through personally, I just bring it out the way it is. And surprisingly, when I bring it out, so many people identify with that. Yeah, I sing my experiences. I sing people's experiences. I sing what I see happening. I sing what I see in the Bible. Yeah. No, this is what happened. Mpongo Wakando song was supposed to be a wedding song, initially. Yeah, it was supposed to be a wedding song. So I remember when we were planning to go to studio, we prayed and we told God, because we just had the title, Mpango Wakando. We didn't have the body. So we went to studio at Busy Bees, and he began working on the track, began building the track. And by there, I've written many songs just in studio, just listening to a track. Usually, like the band we used to have, we could meet and they just begin playing randomly, and then a song would come. And we do the song, and we minister on Sunday with that and that song. So that song came when we were in studio. The inspiration just came. Like I said, it was supposed to be a wedding song. It was supposed to be for marriages. But then when we go to studio, God just turned things around, and I just felt these ideas came coming down. Then I wrote. By there, we did not even sing everything we wrote down. So that's how it came. Well, there might have been things that were happening, but I wouldn't say this particular song came because of that. I don't know. I don't know whether to say that. But I always have a different story when it comes to Mpango Wakando, the song, because of the way it came. You know, this is 2016. Julia. Go 2016, 2015, first, with whatever happened in 2016. You know what, Chwea? The Bible is our manual. The Bible, it is our manual. And people need to understand what forgiveness is. By the way, I have no problem with anyone. I have none. No problem with anyone. And I have forgiven. If I pray every day. They tell God, you know, when we pray the Lord's Prayer, we say, God, forgive us as we forgive. You cannot say, as I forgive, if you have not forgiven. So I have no enemies, none. Chwea, you are Chwea, right? You are not any other person. You are Chwea. Do you need the wife? You will go for her, right? You cannot send someone to go for, will you? No.
Are you implying Eric has not come to you to ask for?
I'm simply saying, if Edward needs a wife, Edward will go for the wife. If Edward has differed with the wife, Edward will go for the wife. Edward will not go on social media to look for a wife. Social media will not give you a wife. No. The only thing I can say is, I'm fine. You know, Tony, I don't have to go telling people I'm fine. I go before people, I walk around and people tell me, you look fine. You look good. You look peaceful. You look refreshed. And that's the truth. So I'm fine. Nothing else matters. I'm fine with God. I'm fine with my life. I'm fine. We did Stolia with Willy Paul. A lot of things happened. A lot of things went in the air. After that, we did Kitanzi. After that, towards the end of last year, we did Sijafika. I mean, you'd even ask yourself, if I have bad blood with Willy, why would we be working together again? There's nothing wrong. I mean, there's nothing. We are fine. Willy Paul is my spiritual son. We are fine. And that's why we are still ministering together and working together. Yes, and just doing music together. Condemn it. I condemn. What's the spelling of condemn? See, capital condemn. I condemn it. I condemn it highly. And really, I think society, everyone has a responsibility beginning from the parents themselves. I would start there. The Bible is clear. Sorry, I'm quoting the Bible, Sana, because that's who I am. That's how I live. The Bible is clear about how we should bring up our children. And the Bible says if we bring them up in a certain way, they will not deviate from it. So if we bring them up in that way, that means they will not be able to deviate from it. You know? So I would begin by blaming it on parents, on the way they bring up their children. Me, as Gloria. I've never gone to sing in Abba. The other place is club. What is the difference, club and bar? Okay. I've never performed in a club or in a bar. What's up, guys? This is your very own Gloria Muliro hanging out with the best site for breaking news in Kenya, tuko.co.ke. Stay locked.